Thank you. Invocation comes from the same root word as vocation. It is a kind of calling. So even as our graduates prepare to leave this place in search of their calling, their vocation, we now invoke, we call forth the spirit of joy that lightens our load, the spirit of truth that sets us free, the spirit of knowledge that invents vaccines and video cameras and YouTube and a billion other things, and that makes life as we know it possible. The spirit of justice that holds the wealthy and the powerful accountable, and that advocates for the poor and clasps hands in solidarity with our vulnerable neighbors. The spirit of kindness and hope, without which we are not human. The spirit of love that is the final purpose of our being. Together, these are one spirit, the great spirit, the divine spirit. And so now we call forth this spirit. Fill this virtual space. Fill this beautiful place. Fill our hearts and our minds and our vision. Fill us. Be here now.
Good afternoon, and welcome to the Warren Wilson College graduating class of 2021, as well as a few of our 2020 graduates who have been invited to walk across the platform they missed last May at this year's conferring of degrees. While this year's virtual and three in-person ceremonies are very different than the traditional Warren Wilson commencement, it will be absolutely wonderful to be able to be physically present for our graduates and their guests for the presentation of diplomas, and to be able to personally congratulate every deserving Warren Wilson graduate who walks across the platform. Today's ceremonies remind us that we are emerging from a difficult year, and they give us tangible hope for the future. We are told that emerging from the pandemic will not be like flipping a light switch, but more like a dimmer switch, with the lights brightening a little bit at a time. This ceremony is an example, part pandemic virtual, part protocol driven in person. But this is light, and someday, before too long, we will be in full illumination. So welcome to you, graduates, your families and friends, and welcome Warren Wilson faculty, staff, and students. Board members, honored guests, joining me on the virtual platform today to welcome you are Lash Zemp, Chair of the Board of Trustees, Pinky Stegall, Chair of our Alumni Board, and also thank you to Steve Runholt, Pastor of the Warren Wilson Presbyterian Church, for our invocation. I'd also like to introduce all the members of the President's Cabinet. I am very grateful for each and every one of them and for their commitment to this institution and their hard work. Always so, but even more so in the challenging environment we've been working through since March of 2020. Vice President of Academic Affairs, Jay Roberts. Vice President for Applied Learning, Kathy Kramer. Vice President for Student Life, Paul Perrine. Interim Vice President for Enrollment and Marketing, Brian Lechte. Vice President for Advancement, Zan Garland. Vice President for Administration and Finance and Chief Financial Officer, Belinda Burke. I am excited to greet you on this very special day and look forward to seeing our graduates and their guests on campus at our conferring of degrees. To the class of 2021, most of you arrived at Warren Wilson College just after I did in August 2017, and how rewarding it has been to see you change and grow over these last 4 years, as I have also grown into my new role as president. And you have risen to the occasion of finishing your education in a global pandemic. None of us saw that coming back in 2017. I have gotten to know many of you in our conversations about the issues you engage with on campus and in the wider world, and in email exchanges and in SGA meetings each year. I have admired your courage to speak up and stand up, your resilience, your passion, and your hard work. At commencement, presidents always acknowledge the hard work and commitment that led to this glorious moment. But you, my friends, you have truly walked through the fire to get here. In a global pandemic, the likes of which have not been seen since 1918, you have learned online for months, have adapted to COVID protocols at home, at work, and in the classroom, and have experienced the many losses that this pandemic has wrought. And you have been resilient and determined to keep going and finish your college degree. You will remember this time for the rest of your lives, inextricably tied to your college experience. Be proud of that. It has not been easy, but you have triumphed in your arrival at this moment of completion. Like graduates before you, you have prepared for your tests, read many, many pages, written many, many pages, stayed up late studying, gotten up early, done without sleep, overslept now and then, and learned so much about life. Sometimes people act as if college is a protected environment, somehow not real life. I always say at commencements that that perception of college as not real life is not true, and especially not true here at Warren Wilson College, where college is a place where you step out in courage, stand up for what you believe, question what you believe. But in addition to what I always say, I must add, you still did this in a pandemic, in a historic and necessary reckoning with racial justice across the country and in the world, in a time of national polarization and division, and during a siege on the capital of our country. You have stepped up as students and as humans during all of this, as activists who seek to change the world. Notable examples of what Warren Wilson College wants its students and alumni to be. To say congratulations is not enough. You are heroes. Know that we are walking beside you as you go into your next chapters. And I say chapters because there is not just one, but many. We at Warren Wilson College will always be a part of you, and we are in your corner, rooting for you every step of the way. Others have walked beside you and have been a part of you during your journey at Warren Wilson College. Would you please, class of 2021, think of those who have supported you, parents, partners, aunts, uncles, grandparents, siblings, friends, faculty, and staff, and wherever you are right now, take a minute to give them a heartfelt round of applause. Please know that all of us at the college want to know what you are up to many years into the future. You are about to become our alumni, and I hope you will remain engaged with this special place for years to come. I will see you at homecoming, in person, in future years, and please follow Wilson on social media. Stay in touch. Now I have the pleasure of introducing Lash Zimp, Chair of the Warren Wilson Board of Trustees. Lash moved to Western North Carolina more than 18 years ago after 20 years of working in Alaska in the commercial fishing industry and practicing law in Juneau, Alaska. He attended Davidson College and then earned a law degree from the University of New Hampshire School of Law, formerly Franklin Pierce Law Center. He recently joined Outward Bound USA as its risk management director. Previously, he was a partner with the Asheville law firm of Roberts & Stevens with 30 years of experience trying cases and representing a variety of professional, outdoor recreation, industry, and business interests in state and federal courts. A frequent presenter at the North Carolina Youth Campus Association, Lash has also been invited to speak at the National Conference of the American Camp Association. He is very involved with the Asheville and Western North Carolina communities, joining our Board of Trustees in 2015. He has previously served on the boards of the Southern Appalachian Highlands Conservancy, WCQS Public Radio, Pisgah Legal Services, the Asheville Chamber of Commerce, and Riverlink. He is an active member of the North Carolina Association of Defense Attorneys, currently serving as immediate past president. Please join me in welcoming Lash Zemp.
Greetings to you, the Warren Wilson community, parents, family, friends, honored guests, faculty, staff, friends of the college, and most importantly, the class of 2021. On behalf of the Board of Trustees of Warren Wilson College, I welcome and congratulate you for your achievement, an achievement during a year like no other during my lifetime. Class of 2021, you are to be congratulated for not only for the significant accomplishment of receiving your degree with great success, but for your resilience and perseverance in doing so this year. A year in which the stress from fear of a crippling pandemic permeated every aspect of our lives like wood smoke from a fire. A year in which a horrific 9-minute video of a black man murdered at the hands of police provided a long overdue catalyst that has begun to lift the blinders to the injustices deeply embedded with a society built on white power. A year in which false and dangerous narratives drove our politics to the place where our nation's capital was stormed and ransacked. While it has been a year of upheaval and turmoil, it has also been a year that demonstrates the importance, the relevance of this place, of your education at Warren Wilson College. Your time here has taught you to think and to become thinkers. When you lift a rock from a stream to see and study what is under it, what you find causes you to ask questions about what you have found. This is true not only for science, but in all aspects of your studies here and for our society. I urge you as you move into the next stage of your life's exploration to continue to lift the rocks of our community, our country, our culture, our society, and continue to ask the necessary and essential questions, questions that are long overdue and oftentimes, most times, more important than the answers. Dr. Hans Rosling, a Swedish physician and professor of international health and a founder of the Gapminder Foundation, died in 2017. But in 2020, his son and daughter-in-law posthumously published for Dr. Rosling his best-selling book, Factfulness. If you have not read this important work, I encourage you to do so. There, Dr. Rosling writes as follows, and I quote, "We find simple ideas very attractive. We enjoy that moment of insight. We enjoy feeling we really understand or know something. And it is easy to take off down a slippery slope from one attention-grabbing simple idea to feeling that this idea beautifully explains or is the beautiful solution for lots of other things. The world becomes simple. Everything is simple. It saves a lot of time to think like this. You can have opinions and answers without having to learn about a problem from scratch, and you can get on with using your brain for other tasks. But it's not so useful if you like to understand the world. Being always in favor of or always against a particular idea makes you blind to information that doesn't fit your perspective. Instead, constantly test your favorite ideas for weaknesses. Be humble about the extent of your expertise. Be curious about new information that doesn't fit and information from other fields. And rather than talking only to people who agree with you or collecting examples that fit your ideas, see people who contradict you, disagree with you, and put forward different ideas as a great resource for understanding the world. Warren Wilson College has provided you with these critical skills to question and think and ask. This is what the world calls you to do. I congratulate you and wish you all the very best as you continue to face the important questions ahead. Thank you very much.
The Warren Wilson experience is transformational for many of our graduates, and they stay connected to the college for many years. To congratulate the class of 2021, I would like to introduce the chair of our alumni board, Pinky Stegall, class of 2007.
Hi friends, I'm Pinky Stegall, class of 07 and alumni board president. I know it's been a long journey for each of you to get here, and I'd like to give you my deepest congratulations on behalf of all our alumni. As you go out into the world, you'll stumble across others from your tribe from time to time, whether in your hometown or in a random city on the other side of the world. You'll get excited when you see an owl tattoo and leave notes on people's windshields when you spot a Wilson sticker in the parking lot. It takes a special kind of person to go to Warren Wilson. And though we're all products of a different time, we're all cut from the same cloth. This valley is your home, just like it is for the class of 1971, and 1981, and 2001. And throughout your life, it will always be here for you to return to. It will evolve with the times, just as it did to become the place you've attended, but it will always be here for you. Take the things you've learned here, and as you go out into the world, make it a little more like the Swannanoa Valley, and bring good news back, and tell us all about it. Congratulations to each of you, and welcome to your alumni family. We're all so, so proud of you.
Greetings, I'm Kathy Kramer, the Vice President for Applied Learning, and it is my honor today to present the Staff Teaching Excellence Award for 2021. This award recognizes the importance of our staff members in student learning at Warren Wilson. Students are impacted in transformative ways by their relationships with our staff, who are educators, supervisors, and mentors. I am very pleased to announce that our winner for this year is Melanie Wilder, Supervisor of the Fiber Arts Craft Crew. There were two themes that came through loud and clear as students and colleagues talked about Melanie. One is her extensive knowledge of fiber arts, craft history, and the local community, along with her ability to share that knowledge with others in a way that inspires and motivates them. Another is her commitment to her students, their work, and their lives, creating a supportive and stimulating work-learning environment. As a supervisor, Melanie shares her expertise, but always empowers students to find their own pathways. One explained, she expertly walks the line between giving the students she works with space to explore their own ideas while also being there to support them when they need it. Crew members talked about that skill-building process, saying, Melanie teaches us so much about crafting and the history of crafting culture. I've learned lots of skills from her and also the entrepreneurial business side of making art. This education has played a critical role in vocational exploration. One student noting, she created a space for me to explore a world I had interest in but never had the chance to experience. She has given me the opportunity to go into a field that I'm very passionate about. Melanie has grown the program to include a dye garden and offerings such as felting, weaving, sewing, and basket making. The crew's products and art installations are campus favorites, and she has also extended her impact through community engagement, working with her students to bring fiber arts to after-school programs and local events. Dean of Work Paul Bobbitt describes Melanie as an insanely talented artist, teacher, and collaborator. but it is her heart, he says, that stands out the most. She brings love to her work that is inspiring and infectious. Thank you, Melanie, for all you do, and congratulations.
Thank you.
Hi, I'm Jay Roberts, Vice President for Academic Affairs, and it is my honor to announce the Faculty Teaching Excellence Award for 2020-2021. The Faculty Teaching Excellence Award recognizes the positive influence of effective teaching on student development and honors faculty members for their contributions to student learning. Professor Siti Kusujiarti is this year's recipient of the Faculty Teaching Excellence Award. Siti joined the faculty in 2000 and earned her PhD in sociology at the University of Kentucky. Since starting her tenure at Warren Wilson, Professor Kusujiarti has been deeply interested in teaching and research. She's developed innovative curriculum for courses such as environmental sociology, societies in Southeast Asia, gender, development, and the environment, and disaster and society, as well as a number of study away courses to Vietnam, Thailand, and Indonesia. Professor Kusujiarti is also a performer, bringing classical Javanese dances to life with the Warren Wilson Gamelan Ensemble year after year. Professor Kusujiarti embodies being an engaged and present teacher who consistently pushes her students towards the kind of rigorous questioning and critical thinking that has the capacity to transform their lives. Students recognize Professor Kusujiarti as having a profound impact on their lives, with one student calling her just about my most favorite professor, not just my advisor, not just one of my work crew supervisors, but a scholarly role model, an incredible feminist, a mentor, a confidant, and someone I consider chosen family. Multiple student nominations point to exceptional research opportunities Professor Kusujiarti has provided, describing encouragement, academic research connections, conference presentations, and mentorship. In 2020 alone, Professor Kusujiarti published 5 articles and book chapters on topics so varied as riskscapes, families, national parks, water rights, and climate change, placing the role of gender at the center of these topics. Notably, she has published with an array of former students, including 3 alumni with whom she studied in post-tsunami Aceh, Indonesia, where they studied Sharia law through community-engaged fieldwork. Across 2 decades, Professor Siti Kusujiarti has helped students to re-envision the world by shifting their understanding of it in small yet radical ways through her teaching, both inside and outside the classroom. Please join me in congratulating Professor Siti Kusujiarti on this more than deserving achievement. Siti.
I am pleased to announce the 2021 Algernon Sidney Sullivan Award recipient is Zella Roberts. Zella was a creative force on Spiritual Life Crew, helping to plan numerous innovative and successful interfaith programs throughout their time on crew. Zella has been a regular at spiritual events during their time on campus, connecting their own faith journey and quest for justice into their work. These are the words of their crew supervisor and religious studies instructor, Matt Hoffman. And this describes the incredible rootedness that Zella has brought to their experience at Warren Wilson. During their time at the college, they have worked on Spiritual Life Crew, have been a regular break worker, and played a pivotal role with the Student Workers Union, rooting such work and advocacy in their deep connection to both their faith and their beliefs. Moreover, Zella has started various initiatives on campus geared at first-generation college student support and transition, from creating a student club, working class heroes, and advocating for additional access to food and resources for students over breaks and during the summer. This past semester, Zella worked with Asheville Poverty Initiative, API, the nonprofit organization founded by our new college chaplain, Shannon Spencer. Zella's grounding in spiritual practice led them to this internship because they wanted to participate in faith that was doing something to heal communities. They were so inspired by the mission of API's 12 Baskets Cafe that they started an informal pantry at Sonic, where they also worked part-time. Zella shared, "I just started bringing in food from the cafe for some of our employees that I knew were food insecure. Within days, others started bringing in food too to share. My manager loved the idea, and now it's being shared at other Sonics." Matt Hoffman noted that as a social work major and interfaith leadership minor, Zella embodies a deep commitment to spirituality and its connection to justice, particularly economic and racial justice. Connecting spirituality and religion to their passion for food access and social work has become a hallmark of their work. Zella embodied the connection between spirituality and work and has used their connection to both Judaism and Christianity as a jumping off point to serve others and reach out. They have raised their hand in constant helpfulness. Matt notes that Zella consistently challenged me to rethink and reimagine the connections between spirituality, justice, and service in my own teaching and learning. Zella seeks out opportunities to make the work a more just, equitable place. They embody deeply the ideals of the Algernon Sidney Sullivan Award and the importance that spirituality plays in movements for justice. We are thrilled to see where their next steps lead. Congratulations, Zella Roberts. Since 1942, the Alton F. Poff Cup has been awarded to a graduating senior who demonstrates integrity, common sense, a willingness to work, and a commitment to growth and progress. Mr. Poff was a 1929 graduate of the Asheville Farm School. He was the first president of the Warren Wilson Alumni Association and a member of the Board of Trustees. The Poff Cup is awarded to a student who excels in all areas of our educational program: academics, work, community engagement, and campus life. Nominations are solicited from the community, and a committee of faculty and staff chooses the finalists who appear on a ballot given to all employees who vote for the winner. This year's Poff Cup was made by Warren Wilson College Fine Woodworking Crew members Wyatt Sutter, Jeremy Epstein, and instructor Ben Blackmar. It is made from wood grown on our campus. The cup is aged spalted poplar, the pedestal is white oak, and the base is red oak darkened with iron oxide stain. Before I present the 79th Poff Cup, I would like to recognize all four of our exceptional finalists for the award, each of whom has excelled in multiple ways within the college. To be selected as a finalist is an honor and reflects the positive and lasting impact that each of these students has made at Warren Wilson College. Riley Baker, Brenton Davis, Susie Lusardi, Michelle Padron. Congratulations to all of you for your achievements here and the recognition of your faculty and staff. I am now pleased to announce that this year's Poff Cup recipient is Michelle Padron. As a social work major, Michelle participated in a unique Intro to Social Work course. Warren Wilson College is the only liberal arts institution in North Carolina participating in the Inside Out program, which brings together campus-based students with incarcerated students for semester-long credit-bearing courses held in prison. Warren Wilson partners with the Swannanoa Correctional Center for Women. Michelle also participated in our intercultural communication course through Inside Out. She was a quiet leader in the group inquisitive, and committed to promoting equity and inclusion. As a result of her engagement in that course, she co-presented about our inside-out teaching and learning experiences at the Workshop on Intercultural Skills Enhancement Conference at Wake Forest University. In Dr. Lucy Lawrence's Advocacy from the Ground Up course, Michelle and other students participated in Social Work Advocacy Day at the North Carolina General Assembly. Michelle was part of a small group of students who developed a policy brief on the necessity to ban conversion therapy. In Raleigh, Michelle and her group met with the Buncombe County senators and representatives about their research, and the language from the students' policy brief was used in House Bill 516, the bill that Governor Roy Cooper signed into law in August 2019. Michelle has also been on the Creative Writing MFA crew, a crew member of the writing studio, and on the WIDE crew. As a tutor in the writing studio, she traveled to Columbus, Ohio, for a grant-funded presentation with Dr. Julie Wilson and a group from the writing studio at the International Writing Centers Association. As a leader of the student life crew in the WIDE office, Michelle was a member of the Alma Shippey Coalition, a regular attender for Black student union events, and a speaker at WIDE organized program Space, a place to talk about race. During the pandemic, Michelle drove students to the vaccination clinic at UNCA during our vaccination event. From her very first semester at Warren Wilson, Michelle began engaging in deep and meaningful community engagement on her own, through her courses, and through additional academic pursuits. She spent more than a semester supporting Manos, a program that connects Warren Wilson College students with Latinx high school students as mentors and tutors. Michelle has led our college community in equity work. Dr. Shuli Archer has said of her, in part, "What has impressed me most over the past few years is Michelle's commitment to speaking truth to power. This phrase, popularized by Bayard Rustin, represents a person's commitment and drive to tell the truth, the real, raw, and painful truth, to people in positions of authority. Michelle has done this again and again, with her story, with the lived experiences of her peers and closest friends, to bring a reckoning to the college. She speaks for what she knows to be true and to bring accountability to not only our institution, but to the many spaces that she has navigated." Michelle's internship in 2019 was at Verner Center for Early Learning, where she assisted teachers and helped children de-escalate PTSD symptoms. This internship led to her being offered an internship with Child Protective Services. In 2020, she was a Z. Smith Reynolds Fellow and interned at Pisgah Legal Services, where she worked on the immigration team as a Spanish language translator for clients in legal proceedings, scheduled appointments with clients, and conducted needs assessments. In January 2020, Michelle participated in a short-term study abroad course in Cuba, taught by Dr. Lucy Lawrence and Melissa Davis. Dr. Lawrence said, "Michelle was an indispensable member of the group with her maturity, intercultural insights, fearlessness, and commitment to group learning. As the culmination of her semester-long research and 10-day field study in country, Michelle wrote a scholarly paper on race in Cuba. Her paper explored nuances of race on the island nation, noted historical complexities of race within the revolution, and included contemporary perspectives from Afro-Cubans. Her paper, much like her other work at Warren Wilson, demonstrated her critical thinking skills, expertise in written communication, and ability to authentically connect with others." During her final semester at Wilson, Michelle has completed her social work field practicum at NC Brookhaven, a local behavioral and mental health organization. Through her 330 plus hours in the field, Michelle worked on the Interdisciplinary Assertive Community Treatment, ACT team, providing person-centered services to individuals who are at risk of hospitalization, homelessness, and substance abuse. It's no wonder NC Brookhaven has been as blown away with Michelle as we have been at Warren Wilson College. Through professional networking, Michelle will begin her employment at Trinity Place Runaway and Homeless Youth Shelter upon graduation. Please join me in congratulating Michelle Padron on her many accomplishments as well as the presentation of the PAF Cup. To speak on behalf of our graduating class, it is my pleasure to introduce this year's senior speaker, Bridget Palmer. Their message to the graduating class of 2021 was chosen by their peers, and we're pleased to have Bridget address the class today. Introducing Bridget is Philip Otterness, Professor of History.
It is my great pleasure to introduce this year's senior speaker, Bridget Palmer. Bridget exemplifies all that is wonderful about Warren Wilson students, both in the classroom and out. Bridget has been a valued member of the library work crew, both helping out at the circulation desk and scrounging up hard-to-find books on interlibrary loan. They have been a model of student engagement, serving on student government, working for racial justice as part of the Alma Shippey Coalition, and taking on the high-profile demands of being student representative on the Board of Trustees. Of course, what many of us remember most is Bridget's presence in the classroom. Smart, articulate, engaged. The qualities that got them on the dean's list every semester they have been here and that made them the co-winner of this year's award for Outstanding Senior in History and Political Science. Prepare yourself for a treat. Bridget Palmer.
Hello, everyone. I'm speaking to you today from the Morris Pavilion in our beautiful Swannanoa Valley. To all of my classmates, as well as our family, friends, faculty, staff, administrators, and trustees, welcome, and thank you for being here. Thank you especially to Tachi Smith and the rest of the commencement committee for their tireless work in coordinating this event, as well as my fellow graduates who have selected me to be the senior speaker. While I do wish that we could be celebrating commencement together in person, I must admit I am relieved to be doing this virtually. The path to graduation is rarely easy, but the challenges we have faced as a class feel unique. Though we are graduating into an uncertain world, we have cultivated the curiosity, empathy, and integrity necessary to thrive. We are a class defined by our adaptability. Despite the realities of pandemic living and distance learning, we have engaged deeply in our academics, work, and community engagement. We have fought to better our campus, our world, ourselves. We have made art, acted as stewards for the earth, embarked on research projects, competed in athletics, and treasured thousands of little moments that together will come to characterize our time at Warren Wilson. I invite and challenge you to dwell on the good, the times of joy, optimism, and exhilaration, and connection. Our nostalgia will be tinted with grief for the senior year we could have had. While the moments of pain and hardship are certainly there and should not be forgotten, I hope that they are outweighed. In the words of retiring librarian May Ma, we do the big things right. Among the big things I would count are commitment to community, dedication to justice, readiness to help, preparation for a more sustainable future, and care for the world. The qualities and skills we have developed at Warren Wilson will last for a lifetime. Think of the workday projects, the capstone presentations, the art installations, the concerts, the tournaments, the internships. Each one has been a demonstration of our values. Our hard work, diligence, and resilience empower each of us for success in our next chapters, whatever that may look like for you. I won't give you some stock statement about entering the real world. We know what the real world is, and we have been living in it already. This isn't the commencement any of us expected, but it is a joy nonetheless. Congratulations to the class of 2021. We've made it.
It is my pleasure and privilege to welcome our speaker today, Mr. Andrew Revkin, founding director of the Initiative on Communication and Sustainability at Columbia University's Earth Institute. As one of America's most honored and experienced environmental journalists, Mr. Revkin has built programs, courses, tools, and collaborations, bridging communication gaps between science and society to cut climate risk and boost social and environmental resilience. Revkin has written on climate change for more than 30 years, reporting from the North Pole to the White House, the Amazon rainforest to the Vatican, mostly for the New York Times. He has held positions at National Geographic and Discover magazine and won the top awards in science journalism multiple times, along with a Guggenheim Fellowship. Revkin has also written acclaimed books on the history of humanity's relationship with weather, the changing Arctic, global warming, and the assault on the Amazon rainforest, as well as three book chapters on science communication. Two very different films have been based on his work, Rockstar and the triple Golden Globe winning 1994 HBO film, The Burning Season, based on Revkin's biography of slain rainforest defender Chico Mendez. A lifelong musician, he was also a frequent accompanist of Pete Seeger and is a performing songwriter. I can say, in addition to these many accolades, that Andrew is incredibly easy to work with. He was originally scheduled to be our commencement speaker last year. We all know why that didn't happen. Despite the many challenges associated with inviting him as our speaker, he took it all in stride, including our need for him to deliver this address virtually this year. We're thrilled to have him as our commencement speaker. Please join me in welcoming Mr. Andrew Revkin.
Greetings and congratulations, Warren Wilson College Class of 2021. And congratulations as well to faculty, staff, families, and friends. What a moment this is. You face a disrupted landscape of change like nothing I've seen in my 65 years on this planet, 35 of which I've spent probing some of the world's worst environmental problems and solutions as a journalist. It can be paralytic and draining to confront a future that feels like you're forced to play speed chess while walking through a fog-cloaked maze of tripwires and landmines and the rest. It can seem unbelievable at times, but I wake up each day hopeful and engaged, and I hope to convince you this isn't wishful thinking. First, wherever you are, whatever you're doing, please stop and take a deep breath. Then let it out. I mean, really. Maybe one or two more, actually. You've earned a breather. And there's a long journey ahead. To help, here's an inspiring moment from my Sustain What webcast when Karen Alley, a hardworking young climate scientist at the University of Alberta, joined us and thrillingly played a hypnotic hammered dulcimer composition called Into Open Air.
Wow.
Thanks.
Wow, that was
I did the trick.
That was great. Oh my God, Karen, I am absolutely enthralled with this hammer dulcimer now, man. I mean, I'm first of all, how does this even happen?
I just love the reaction of the comedian Chuck Nice, who's deeply focused on climate change, even in his comedy, but also on the human connections that can come through laughter. And those connections are the source of solutions. These arts-focused Sunday shows are my soul boost after weekdays spent digging in on past the pandemic, on clean energy policy, on disaster preparedness, and the rest. Karen Alley uses music to stay centered. I use music. I use community, walks in the woods with my wife and our dogs. You know what soothes your spirit. Don't lose that amid what feels like endless urgency, finding a job, staying safe, and all the rest. Yes, on an even bigger scale, urgent work is required to address sustainability challenges, but there too, I recommend blending any sense of urgency with some patience. Those words may seem weird in the same sentence, but I'll try to explain why that feels necessary to me. We've been in surge mode so far, going from 2.7 billion people when I was born in 1956 toward 8 billion now, with the world population almost certainly hitting 9 billion by 2050. Just in the last three decades, humans have emitted more than 800 billion tons of CO2, heat-trapping gas into the atmosphere, nearly 40 billion tons just last year, even with the great global slowdown from the pandemic. That's certainly not the kind of emergency break we need going forward. But perhaps this great pause, as some have called this past year, offers your generation and everyone alive today a sense of what societal characteristics might produce a better human journey going forward. Imagine an economy that truly, concretely values the caregivers, maintainers in our lives, that values the makers and responders among us in ways that are missed in the current economic models that grew out of the last century or two. Imagine building a clean energy system that empowers lives and livelihoods from rural Appalachia to urbanizing Africa. Imagine building a less polluted information system, one that makes the most of global internet connectedness, transparency, and knowledge sharing, while limiting the toxic, dangerous polarization, hate, and fakery. It's doable with urgency and patience. One tip for sure, don't unplug, please. The world needs you online. It may feel like hard work. I don't mean addicted online. I mean engaging constructively. If you give up, the haters and disinformers will happily fill your space. Think of it like a workout, like a practice, like yoga, like physical fitness. Then turn it off for a bit. But when you see a novel species of insect, for example, rev up the phone and post the inspiring image on iNaturalist. Sharing information, sharing joy and wonder can build a better world. Here's one more bit of imagining. Imagine the value of cultivating and spreading the capacity to have an adaptive mind. To me, this may be the single most important goal right now in a century of rapid change, layers of uncertainty, and enormous consequence. It's a concept championed by Susie Moser, a social scientist working to build resilient communities and policies in the face of climate change. But its value goes way beyond climate. Susie explains that an adaptive mind is a set of traits, leadership skills, and capacities that allow an individual embedded in social networks and institutions to respond with agility, creativity, resolve, and resilience, and to do so when facing pervasive uncertainty, traumatic experiences, or the anticipation of trauma, and challenges associated with deep, systemic, and transformative change. Ponder those words and think about the world around you. Seems like a pretty great fit to me these days. Susie's work is sufficiently important that I hope you'll explore her ideas at this internet shortcut, j.mp/adaptivemindproject, no spaces. So how do we get there? The good news is that the Warren Wilson community is already on this journey. When I visited your school in 2009 for a Headwaters environmental conference, I marveled at your living, working campus with the productive farm and forests, as important to the learning as the classrooms. I loved how the focus on scientifically measured environmental performance and performing arts as well links Warren Wilson with the wider Appalachian community. I've tried to keep track since then, and I was excited to see how the Appalachian Studies curriculum has further connected scholarship and rural society. And now you're among the leaders on the top sustainable colleges list. And in 2020, Warren Wilson not only fully divested from fossil fuels, the school also became a case study in responsible and productive investment in companies and funds building a better future. Best of all, in almost every instance, students, you have been leading these efforts. And the work continues. Just last week, I visited Warren Wilson's Facebook page and saw biology major Sophie Allen tackling plastic waste produced by the 3D printer in the Creative Technologies Lab. We need creative technologies in abundance, but we also need to track what's coming in and going out as we build this new future. Sophie's automated spooling system, just like my stories, may not save the planet on its own, but it's a step in a great direction. When tackling huge systemic challenges like the global surge of plastic waste or global warming, what's needed is motivation, innovation, communication, and sustained assessment to know what's working or not. I just want to leave you with a quick final set of tips I find useful when navigating complex challenges. First, don't wait for clarity. Some of those listening now might have attended that Headwaters gathering in 2009. If you were there, you probably heard a great take on acting amid uncertainty from one of the pioneers of ecological economics, Herman Daly. As he put it, when you jump out of an airplane, you need a crude parachute more than you need an accurate altimeter. I couldn't agree more. In the context of the climate crisis, more than enough is known to act now to cut local vulnerability to today's climate hazards, while also pursuing global cuts in heat-trapping pollution. We can do more than one thing at once, right? Second tip, embrace diversity. Americans, all too slowly, have begun the hard work of grappling with and overcoming centuries of aversion to racial diversity. Here I'm talking about embracing diversity of views and sources of expertise. One of my biggest mistakes in my 33 years of reporting on climate change was spending too much time talking to climate scientists. That may seem weird. I love climate scientists. They're amazing pioneers in a tough field, and their work is incredibly interesting. It's taken me from the North Pole to the Amazon rainforest to supercomputer centers in the Rocky Mountains. But it took me until 2006, 18 years of reporting, before I realized what I was missing. That's when I finally began interviewing social and behavioral scientists about the climate challenge, asking them why we seem so stuck. They laid out a mountain of research I had missed in all that time. All that focus on melting glaciers and burning forests, I forgot to look at the inconvenient mind in here. Research showing vividly why big risks can hide in plain sight, why we haven't really confronted climate change despite such clear evidence. When you have time, go to the web shortcut j.mp/scariestscience to read an essay of mine describing what I found in more detail. This body of science is indeed scary, but it's also invaluable and points toward powerful steps for cooperation and action, even amid disagreement. Social and behavioral scientists still all too rarely convene with what some call the hard sciences. Of course, it's all hard science, as any sociologist and psychologist would tell you. The reality is the climate challenge cannot be tackled effectively without both, and they have to be in the room, they have to have fluency, and then they have to have ways to connect with the wider public. This leads to my third point, composed of a single word: listen. Most of my storytelling journey has been one-way street, telling stories. Listening is the key to progress amid complexity and conflict. Solutions emerge when there's back and forthing. A friend of mine at Columbia, a psychologist named Peter Coleman, runs a project called the Difficult Conversations Laboratory. I'd love to see one in every community on Earth, as you can imagine. A key tactic they find when looking for cooperation amid deep differences is listening. And I mean really active listening, not the kind of impatient listening I and other journalists typically do when we're just waiting for the perfect soundbite to come along and then we quote it, snip it, edit it, and go forward. Or the other kind of listening in conversations you may know, where you're really sometimes just waiting to make your point more than actively absorbing what the other person is saying or feeling. This is a vital practice facing a problem as complex as climate change, in which we actually need what some ecologists call response diversity. That's this idea that ecosystems, when they're stressed out, they've found that the ones that do best, that are most resilient, are the ones that have species that have a variety of responses to a stress, not all the same. In our society, we need edge pushers. We need group huggers. Imagine how humanity would have fared tens of thousands of years ago if we had all hung back by the fire or all headed out over the next ridge. We probably wouldn't be here. The world right now is too complex, for example, for one energy path. So we need more. How do we have the conversations that foster the capacity to do that? They involve listening. Sadly, I can't do that with you today, given that this is a one-way talk, but please follow up with me at Revkin on Twitter or by email. Find me on the Columbia website. I'll offer one final tip. Don't discount love and faith. That may sound weird coming from a science writer, but here's what I mean. Our challenge is fitting humanity's infinite aspirations on a finite planet and pursuing global well-being are often delineated by data. What's the rate of warming, the loss of species, the level of poverty that we pursue? The menu of choices societies face can be expanded by science and technology. Genetically engineered foods could help end hunger. Safer, smaller nuclear plant designs and battery breakthroughs could help slow warming. But the choices we make will be shaped mainly by our values, not numbers, by how much we value others, other people, other species, including generations yet to come. And faith? I don't mean religion specifically. I mean faith in the potential goodness in every person and the leap of faith that's necessary in making a choice when facing big unknowns. Don't take my word for this. In 2014, at the end of a week-long scientific meeting at the Vatican on sustainable humanity, I turned to the legendary 96-year-old oceanographer, Walter Munk, physical oceanographer. He helped win World War II by building wave forecasting models, making it possible to do beach landings with some confidence in the weather. So I asked Walter, after all that time, all of his decades of work, what do you think it'll take for humanity to have a smooth journey in this century? He turned to me. I assumed he was going to say something technological about carbon capture, or fusion power, or maybe political will. What he said was this. He said, "This will require a miracle of love and unselfishness." Walter passed away at age 101 in 2019, but his vision of the future will be with me the rest of my life. Thank you, and here's to a stirring and productive journey ahead for all of us.
Welcome, class of 2021. And welcome, class of 2020, if you're able to join us today. Welcome to your family, your friends, your loyal supporters. I have to tell you, it's a little bit of an emotional moment for me to see you here in person. We've had a virtual commencement and an in-person commencement. What better metaphor for turning the lights back on? We are moving. I am so proud of each and every single one of you. Joining me today in academic regalia is Lash Zimp, the chair of the Board of Trustees, right over there. Also, Vice President for Academic Affairs, Jay Roberts. And Vice President for Applied Learning, Kathy Kramer. As I said in my remarks, you are heroes. You have made it. Against odds, you have persevered. Congratulations. And now I will call on the Vice President for Academic Affairs, Dr. Jay Roberts, to join me for the presentation of the degrees.
Thank you, President Morton. President Morton, I have the honor to present the following candidates for the Bachelor of Arts or Bachelor of Science. They have satisfied all the requirements and have been approved by the faculty. I now ask you by your official act to confer upon them their degrees.
By the authority vested in me by the trustees of Warren Wilson College, I confer upon you the degree of Bachelor of Arts or Bachelor of Science. I admit you to its rights and privileges and remind you of its responsibilities.
Congratulations, class of 2021. Please give yourselves a round of applause. Will the class of 2021 now come forward to receive your diplomas and a white pine seedling in recognition of your achievements in work and community engagement? Sophie A. Allen. Sienna Isabel Argamon, in absentia. Oliver Robert Armstrong Davies. Riley Nicole Baker. Lauren Fay Ballard. Jui Roshni Barat, in absentia. Sierra Ansley Bell. Cyril Abraham Benson. Gabriel Jeffrey Bortz. Catrice Cade. Taylor Lee Carpenter.
Congratulations.
Virginia Davis. Rosa Teresa Dews, in absentia. Amanda Sophia Hopkins. Lucy Ann Hutchison, in absentia. Sasha Melanie Jacobo, in absentia. Anna Mariah Johnson.
Congratulations.
Kirsten Keith Peterson.
Congratulations.
Ian Samuel Kent McClue, in absentia. Kimberly Ellen Lowe.
Congratulations.
Susan Elizabeth Lusardi.
Congratulations.
Eric Johan Mangs.
Congratulations.
Taylor Jean Marcotte. James Brigham Mayer. Alexander James Mazar. Emily Ann Oostveen. Ashley Pacheco Lujano, in absentia. Molly Elizabeth Patton.
Congratulations.
Gabriel Grace Peterson.
Congratulations.
Elliot Henry Segrest Jones in absentia. Catherine Ray.
Congratulations.
Isabel Anna Snee in absentia. Lydia Ruth Tewksbury.
Congratulations.
Hallie Topping Ward.
Congratulations.
Caitlin Marie Zinneker.
Congratulations. Thank you.
Maggie Holler in absentia. Jenna Joyner, class of 2020, welcome back. Eliana McLaughlin, also class of 2020, welcome back.
Congratulations to all of our graduates and their families. You may now proceed to the reception area where you will have the opportunity to take more pictures and celebrate. Welcome, class of 2021. And welcome back, those of you from the class of 2020 who are joining us today. In academic regalia today, I would like to introduce Lash Zimp, Chair of the Board of Trustees. Joining me on the platform is Dr. Jay Roberts, Vice President for Academic Affairs. And our own Vice President for Applied Learning, Kathy Kramer. Welcome to your family, your friends, your supporters on this beautiful day as we gather to celebrate all of your achievements. I have to tell you, it's an emotional moment, always at commencement, but even more so this year, seeing you in person after our global pandemic and all we have been through together. As I said in my remarks, you are heroes. Yay, you. You have made it. You have endured. You have persevered. And here you are. I will now call on the Vice President for Academic Affairs, Dr. Jay Roberts, to join me for the presentation of degrees.
President Morton, I have the honor to present the following candidates for the Bachelor of Arts or Bachelor of Science. They have satisfied all the requirements and have been approved by the faculty. I now ask you, by your official act, to confer upon them their degrees.
By the authority vested in me by the trustees of Warren Wilson College, I confer upon you the degree of Bachelor of Arts or Bachelor of Science. I admit you to its rights and privileges and remind you of its responsibilities. Will the class of 2021 now come forward to receive your diplomas and a white pine seedling in recognition of your achievements in work and community engagement?
Can we give a round of applause for our graduates?
Sabrina Alicia Alvarado. Samantha Lee Barreras. Logan Bonfield, in absentia. Ivy Blue Breivogel. Henry Trey Brown. Asia India Caldwell. Stephanie Amanda Connor. Brenton Davis. Malaika Rochelle Elix. Camille Roseanne Ference. Batya Emma Globerman. Hope Michelle Hairston. Claire Louisa Harden, in absentia. Griffin J. Harvey. Casey Red Herring. Catherine Ann Horman. Autumn Jade Malier Huff. Elizabeth Hughes. Grace Ann Keith, in absentia. Amelia Lanier. Caroline Amelia Larrick. Michaela Ann Leota. Krista Manning Maney. Callie Marie Mayo. Audrey Shea McDonald Rushing, in absentia. Kaylee Grace McGurk. Erica Benjamin Mead. Robert Donald Mills. Scout Riley Moore.
Andrew Perry Moodry. Michelle Caroline Cardenas Padron. Leela Ann Pellegrino. Jessica Day Prax. Emberlyn Rabin. Zoe Ann Moore Renner. Zella Q. Roberts. Sarah Elizabeth McKenzie Sackman. Grace Noel Serino. Jacob Surfati in absentia. Leo Duva Shannon in absentia. Catherine Tucker Shelady in absentia. Lanzen Sun. Jordana Rebecca Schwartz in absentia. Nicole Natalie Welburn in absentia. Reed M. Williams. Cameron Williams in absentia. Monty Wright. And Heaven Valentine, 2020 grad, welcome back. Congratulations again, class of 2021.
Welcome, class of 2021. And welcome members of the class of 2020 who are able to join us today. Welcome to your family, your friends, your loyal supporters, those who have walked beside you during these last years. Congratulations. This is a beautiful day. Commencement is always an emotional time. But even more so after what we have all done together in this past year and some months. I said in my remarks, you are heroes. You have persevered. You are examples of resilience and what it takes to get where you want to go. We knew you could do it. We had faith in you, and we have faith in you going forward. A couple of people who are in regalia today that I would like to introduce to you. Over here we have Lash Zemp, the chair of the Board of Trustees. Here we have Kathy Kramer, who will be presenting the trees in our customary manner, who is Vice President of Applied Learning. And Jay Roberts, Vice President for Academic Affairs. I will now call on Jay Roberts, the Vice President for Academic Affairs, to join me for the presentation of the degrees.
President Morton, I have the honor to present the following candidates for the Bachelor of Arts or Bachelor of Science. They have satisfied all the requirements and have been approved by the faculty. I now ask you by your official act to confer upon them their degrees.
By the authority vested in me by the Warren Wilson College Board of Trustees, I confer upon you the degree of Bachelor of Arts or Bachelor of Science. I admit you to its rights and privileges and remind you of its responsibilities. Will the class of 2021 and 2020 now come forward to receive your diplomas and a white pine seedling in recognition of your achievements in work and community engagement?
Can we have some applause for the class of 2021, please, and 2020? Benjamin Maxwell Bloom, in absentia. Wendy Gail Boatwright, in absentia. Florence Katerina DeJoffroy. Vivian Templeton Eagleston. Che Angelica Farrell. James Daniel Frazier. Margaret Grace Marie Gross. Ian Heaps. Dan Hill. Sage Draper Kiggins, in absentia. Malcolm Paz Mitchell Bennett. Bridget Palmer. Miguel Santos Garcia. Daniel Schwendinger. Sally Thames. Phoebe Leontine Wessel. Samantha Diane Wicker. Sarah Rhiannon Woody. Bennett H. Lapidus, class of 2020, welcome back. And Ashley Vargas, class of 2020, welcome back.
Please join me in congratulating all of our graduates. You may move your tassels to the left. Please join your family, faculty, and staff in the formal gardens for a reception. Thank you. Before closing the ceremony, I'd like to congratulate all the seniors who received awards, especially Michelle Padron, who received the POF Cup, our highest student award at the college, and Zella Roberts, who received the Sullivan Award. And I also want to acknowledge the faculty and staff on the commencement committee who have worked so hard in this challenging year to make the ceremony happen, as well as all the employees who have continued to serve our students with care this year under challenging circumstances. Thank you, each and every one of you. We look forward to welcoming our graduates with their two guests as they join us on campus tomorrow for the conferring of degrees. At that time, we will officially confer the degrees of Bachelor of Arts and Bachelor of Science upon our graduates and read their names as they cross our stage and receive their diplomas. At Warren Wilson, our graduates also receive a white pine sapling in recognition of their achievements in work and community engagement as a symbol of the experiential learning that is such a special part of our education. Faculty and staff members will be on hand to congratulate, to celebrate, to take pictures, and we will have opportunities for many family photos at that time. Again, my thanks to all of you. Your family members, friends, crew supervisors, faculty, staff, volunteers, and others who help share and shape the experiences of the class of 2021. And let's not forget the class of 2020, some of whom are with us today. We will close with an instrumental version of our alma mater and a benediction from our college chaplain and director of spiritual life, Reverend Shannon Spencer. Please enjoy this evening to celebrate your success, and we will see you in the morning.
And now, friends, the time has come for you to go from this place. And as you go out into the world, go knowing this.
Each and every one of you is a beautiful and beloved child of God, and nothing and no one can ever take that away from you. So go now, like a thousand stars in the night sky, and lead faithfully, creating your own Alleluia.
Go in peace.
Hi, I'm Ashley Costantino. I am the Interim Director of Residence Life and Housing, and I am excited to announce the winner for the Patricia K. and Ernst R. Larson Student Life Award. The funding for this award was given to the college by Pat and Ernst's children, Mark and Denise, as well as family and friends of the Larsons, in recognition of the life-changing impact Ernst and Pat had on students while inspiring them to excel and achieve their full potential. The Larsons combine instructive kindness, nurturing guidance, and wisdom, encourage students to make the most of their opportunities and experience at the college. The Patricia K. and Ernst R. Larson Senior Student Life Award recognizes a graduating senior who has demonstrated outstanding leadership and service to our campus community. This award seeks to recognize a senior who, through the service to the campus community, has also lived out the tenets of our community commitment, including cultivating integrity, responsibility, respect, communication, and sustaining a healthy balance both personally and within our community. Through this generous gift to the college, in addition to a financial award, the fund will donate to a charity of the winner's choice. I'm pleased to announce that this year's winner is Riley Baker. Riley is an extraordinary student and member of the Warren Wilson community. She has served as a resident assistant since her second semester here at Warren Wilson, and her leadership in this position has only grown, especially in the last 2 years as a resident director. Riley's strengths include her ability to handle emergency situations and her communication skills with both staff and students alike. Her commitment to students has helped cultivate a strong and compassionate community in residence life and the broader community. She has also become a trusted and valued member of our staff, working in partnership with the employees in student life. She has served in our emergency on-call rotation, always encouraging the development of a positive living environment and affirming people's concerns. Riley has made my life as her supervisor immensely easier thanks to her competence, reliability, and organization. She's led RA selection for the past 2 years, always completes more than her fair share of assigned tasks, and always takes steps to make sure that the RAs and students in her area and the whole community are feeling supported. She has been the most dedicated student to residence life in my time here, and we are pleased to recognize her leadership. Thank you, Riley, for your years of service dedicated to the Student Life Division, the college, and your fellow students.
Thank you.
There you are. Hug.
My name is Anna Welton, and I'm the Director of Global Engagement, and I have the honor of presenting the International Cross-Cultural Understanding Award. This award is presented to the student whose actions and attitude embody a spirit, knowledge, sensitivity, and awareness that extends beyond cultural borders and, through learning and action, has enriched the community by sharing and demonstrating the importance of the cross-cultural perspective and global experience. I'm thrilled to present this award to Ivy Blue Breivogel, who is so incredibly deserving. Ivy arrived to Warren Wilson, a freshman who was clearly competent, enthusiastic to learn, and already had some international experience under her belt. We snatched her up quickly for the global engagement crew, and it proved to be a match made for the books. Ivy has served on the global engagement crew ever since and has been crew boss for the past 2 years. In this role, Ivy has extended herself over and over again in ways that were far beyond the call of duty, to ensure that our international community members were well supported, engaged, and had access to meaningful adventures and connection. Her junior year, Ivy executed a vision that we are confident will live on for many years to come, which was the establishment of the Worldwide House on campus, which is a residential community dedicated to fostering intercultural understanding. Ivy has led the English Conversation Exchange for 3 years, also aimed at supporting international students, and she has executed a plethora of brilliant international student programming, particularly during the pandemic, which required a lot of creativity. Not only did Ivy excel in her role on the GO work crew, but in her friendships on campus, she perpetually extended herself to our international students, even inviting a student to come live with her and her family when the pandemic hit and campus was forced to close. Ivy will continue this legacy of promoting cross-cultural understanding in higher ed upon graduation. She will begin a master's degree in higher ed at Elon University this fall and will simultaneously work as a graduate student worker in their Global Education Center. We are so incredibly proud of Ivy, and I know I speak for many international students and beyond when I say that she will be sorely missed but forever celebrated here at Warren Wilson.
Hi, my name is Shuli Arye Archer, and I am the Associate Dean of Community Engagement. I am pleased to present the 2021 Frederick G. Oler Senior Community Engagement Award. This award is given as a tribute to Dr. Oler, a beloved teacher, counselor, and friend to countless students. During his 38 years at Warren Wilson, he contributed to the growth of many aspects of the college, including the community engagement program. This year's Oler Award is presented to Zoe Moore Renner. Since arriving in Swannanoa in 2017, Zoe has completed over 1,200 hours of community engagement through her courses, her service as a Bonner, and through various collectives on and off campus. She has built connections throughout Asheville and Buncombe County, approaching the work both through individual relationships and at the policy level. Zoe brings her full self to this work. She has inspired so many of her fellow Wilsonites and has strategized with dozens of them to strive for justice, equity, and liberation. They describe her as dedicated, supportive, and compassionate, as someone who is always showing up in the best ways she can. Community partners see her as committed, professional, and thoughtful, with one sharing, "I have yet to meet another student who stands out like Zoe." She's engaged and engaging, processing what she learns and asking questions about the work that make me think or reconsider. When reflecting on her 4 years at Wilson, Zoe shared, "We have more purpose, more responsibility and accountability, more love. When we have those, these radical acts of what it means to be in reciprocal and respectful community with folks, it's world-changing. We can change the world with involvement, care, and intentionality." Zoe, thank you for all you've done and will continue to do. Congratulations. We're hugging.
Hello, I'm Paul Bobbitt. I'm the Associate Dean of Work, and it is my honor to present this year's Elizabeth G. Martin Senior Work Award. This year's Senior Work Award winner demonstrates that it is more than just working hard that makes an impact. Positive attitude, professional demeanor, reliability, and a warm-hearted personality are all traits that this year's winner brought to their work for the last 4 years. I've had the great pleasure to witness this student at work on multiple occasions and cannot more fully agree with these words. In her nomination letter, admissions supervisor Monique Cote wrote, "They are always on task, and their work ethic is excellent. They are a great example for the new crew members. They put the visiting families above all, and then works the task in the back with great accuracy. They are our crew leader and have trained many tour guides for the future of Warren Wilson College. They are always smiling, have funny stories, and are a true joy to have here. We will miss them terribly and wish them the very best." Admissions counselor Molly Howard had this to say, "They are an outstanding example of what the work program strives to cultivate in Warren Wilson students. They have contributed to our office environment in a multitude of ways, from mentoring first-time crew members to putting new staff members, such as myself, at ease. Their friendly, professional, and capable air have been a gift in an extremely trying time. The admissions office is often a high-stress environment between juggling multiple tours in a day, making connections with visitors, and fielding all manner of phone calls that come to our office, yet they handle all situations with grace and a can-do attitude. They will be sorely missed. It is my honor to present this year's Senior Work Award to Max Gross."